Farming has always been a major part of the economy along Virginia's coastline, but now the region is experiencing the fastest average rate of sea level rise on the Atlantic coast. Sam Turken of local station WHRO reports on how this shift is creating major problems for the area's farmers.
Water levels around Southeast Virginia have risen nearly 20 inches over the past century, and it's estimated they could go up about 7 feet by 2100. So what does all this mean for coastal farmers around here? Lynn Gale is still figuring that out.
This is a seaside farm in an area called Fox Grove. And the barrier islands are about a mile to the east of us. My son farms with me, and we tend about 2,500 acres. Farming is a lifestyle.
Gale's farmed around here for more than 3 decades. He grows commodities, corn, soybean, and something called rapeseed, which produces an oil used for engines and plastics. Gale shows me around a 75-acre field bordering the ocean. Lush soybean crops are everywhere, except for one small patch close to the water.
They were planted here, and you can actually see the salt residue on the soil. Most of those that came up died. Occasional high tides or flood tides, or if there's a nor'easter, this would be underwater right here.
Gale says he's watched the seawater encroach farther and farther up this field over the past decade. About an acre is no longer farmable. It's even worse than another field he used to plant. 20 acres completely failed. This is all worrying Gale's 32-year-old son, Sands. He grew up playing with tractor toys. Now he's taking over the business and says hundreds of thousands of future dollars are at stake.
A third of the acreage that I farm could be right on the water and directly affected by sea level rise. And as it takes more area, then of course I'm gonna have to figure something out.
Nationwide, only the Gulf Coast around Texas and Louisiana is experiencing a faster rate of rising seas. As oceans heat up from climate change, water molecules expand, contributing to sea level rise. Another part of the problem, scientists say the land around Virginia is sinking. Cora Baird studies sea level rise for the University of Virginia's Coastal Research Center. She says during the last ice age thousands of years ago, a glacier covered the Northeast, pushing down on the Earth's crust. Virginia was at the edge of the glacier and actually lifted. Kind of like when you sit on a mattress, the part beneath you sinks, but the area around you bulges up. Baird says those glaciers melted away long ago, but the Earth's crust in this part of Virginia is still reacting.
Now we are still doing the process of settling down as if whoever was sitting on the mattress just stood up.
On top of this, as glaciers continue to melt all over the world, they're sending more water into the oceans. Add all of it up, and it's not a question of if some areas will go underwater, but when. Baird says the water isn't just coming in from the ocean, rivers, and creeks. It's rising from beneath the land, mixing with groundwater and making the soil wetter and saltier. An invisible killer. It's a threat all the way down the Atlantic coast to Florida.
If you feel like it's important to continue farming, and it's important to, you know, keep agriculture a part of our sort of landscape and identity, where we're in such a confined geographical area, if it keeps pushing in from the edges, there's only so many places we can shift to.
Now, there are ways that farmers could hold on for some time. Salt can dehydrate plants to death, or even poison them. So researchers are testing salt-tolerant crops like barley and quinoa. Farmers also can dig ditches and build berms to keep water away, or accept the inevitable.
They love wet soils, and they can actually help to soak up some of that water.
Thelonious Cook runs a sustainable produce farm. No fertilizer or pesticides. Problem is, the farmland is increasingly soggy as groundwater seeps up from below. So when it rains, water flows off the road onto Cook's fields and has nowhere to go. This has killed enough crops the past few years to translate into a $30,000 loss. Cook, who's 42, hopes to adapt to the rising water, but he says there's a good chance farming here could become impossible.
It makes you feel deflated because, you know, you're building something, you know, for the next generation, and you want to make sure that this is here for the next generation.
For PBS News Weekend, I'm Sam Turken on Virginia's Eastern Shore.